Today, I'm going to explain the first lesson in Class 8 Science CBSE, that is Crop Production and Management. Crops are very important in our life because we are depending on crops as staple food. So, before going to the important things in this lesson, we should know the definition of agriculture and what are crops, what are the two different types of crops, in which season these crops are grown. So first one is, what is agriculture? The practice of growing crops on a large scale, that is called as agriculture. What is meant by crop? If same kind of plants are growing at a particular place for food on a large scale, that is called as crop. Based on the availability of water and sunlight, we are dividing the type of crops into kharif and rabi crops. One type requires more sunlight and less water, another type requires less sunlight and more water. So here, what is the first one? Kharif crops. These kharif crops are growing the season. The time period is given, the month June, from June to September, these kharif crops can be grown. So, why we are preferring that month for the kharif crop? The reason is, it requires less sunlight and more water for growing. These are the examples given here. I'll just read for you. Paddy, maize, soybean, groundnut and cotton are the examples for kharif crops. The second one is rabi crops. Rabi crops requires more sunlight and less water. So you can imagine which month it is grown. That is from October month till March or April. That means September month we are sowing the seed and we are doing the harvesting in the month of April or March. Examples for rabi crops are wheat, barley, pea, gram, mustard and linseed. These are the examples for rabi crops. Next, we are going to enter to the main part of this lesson, that is agricultural practices in crop production. What are the agricultural practices we have to follow to get a good yield of a crop? So first one is soil preparation. We have to follow these steps for preparing the soil before cultivating a type of crop and to get a good yield. So we are preparing the soil to sow a seed by these methods: tilling or ploughing, using the implements plough, hoe or cultivator. Second step followed by tilling is leveling using wooden or iron leveler. And third one is applying manures and fertilizers. The third one is optional, depends on the type of the soil. If it requires nutrients, that time we are preferring the third step, or else we can avoid the third step. So first I'll explain what is tilling or ploughing and how this is done. Tilling or ploughing is the method using for loosening and turning the soil before sowing the seeds. This is done by using the agricultural implements, or the tools for it are plough, hoe or cultivator. So plough or hoe we are using for small scale production of crops, cultivator for large scale. So how is this a plough or hoe? So it is like, if you can just imagine, it is connected to a long rod which is made up of wood or iron. One side there will be a part connected to an animal or tractor. So this is called beam. It is made up of wood or iron. The second part is, here we have two parts. One part is the handle, which is given for farmer to hold it or operate it. And next part is going to the soil, that is plough. Here plough share in the case of plough, or bent blade in the case of hoe. that contains a sharpened iron part which is making the loosening or turning process easily. So this is about plow or hoe. If there are many plow or hoe are connected, that is called as cultivator. So cultivator we are using for large scale production, for making our labor easy and time saving. Next, going to leveling. So once we are doing this tilling or plowing, there are chances for formation of lumps of soil called crumbs. So once crumbs are made in the soil, if we are not leveling it, leveling means pressing the soil using leveler, what happens? The moisture will be losing. The second is the irrigation is very difficult in that soil. And third is there are chances for soil erosion. To avoid that, we have to follow the step leveling after doing tilling or plowing the soil using wooden or iron leveler, which is driven by tractor or animal. And next step, I told you, applying manures and fertilizers, it is optional step if the soil is not enriched with any nutrients. And going to the second step, selection of seeds. So this is very important. Why? Because if the seeds are infected or any diseased seeds, if you are selecting for growing, what happens? We cannot expect good yield, and it is not good. Because why? We are not getting any profit after doing this much hard work by growing any kind of crops. So in the case if the farmer is not able to get healthy seeds, we can depend on NSC. What is NSC? National Seeds Corporation. They're providing good healthy seeds to the farmers. We can buy from there. Or else if we have a bulk of seeds, how can we differentiate these healthy seeds or the seeds which are infected? Taking the bulk of seeds to a bucket full of water, leaving for some time, what happens? The healthier seeds are heavy, which sinks down to the bottom of the bucket in the water. Or else we can look into the seeds which are floating on water. Which is floating on water are not healthy seeds, because the inside part is hollow and lightweighted. So it is not healthy. It is eaten by some insect or pest. So it is not good for sowing the or selecting the seed for sowing. So we have this step is very important. Then next is sowing. The sowing is done by these methods: broadcasting, traditional tool using seed drill, or transplantation. These are the methods we are using for sowing. Broadcasting, traditional tool, seed drill and transplantation. So here the first two are manual methods. Broadcasting. What is broadcasting? We are taking the seed manually using hand. We are just sprinkling the seed without thinking about is it going to the proper depth, or is there proper distance between the seeds, or it is eaten by birds or some other insects. Without thinking the future, we are just sprinkling the seeds by broadcasting method. Next is traditional tool. This is done with the help of a long, here this is a type of tool which contains a long tube which is made up of iron or wood. On the top will be having a funnel, and the bottom is connected to a plow with sharp ends. So it is, if it is one, or sometimes this traditional tool, it will be having two or three tubes connected to the plow, so that manually we are putting the seeds to the funnel. It is passing through the long tube and reaching to the soil before the plow is making the furrow. So the seeds are deposited to the soil. So these are the methods which are having disadvantages also. Then next is seed drill. Here we have a funnel shape and many long tubes made of iron are connected to many plow. So what happens? At a time we can sow many seeds, which is having proper depth, going to proper depth, and having enough distance between each seed. Now after doing this process, even the seed drill will be is covering the soil so that no birds can come and eat the seeds which we have sown. Next process is transplantation. What is meant by transplantation? In case some plants, if we cannot grow in a proper field, what we can do? We can first grow the seeds in a nursery, select only the seeds which is very healthy, and transplant or shift to the field where we are planning to grow the crop. So the method saves our time by selecting only the healthy seeds and not wasting time by sowing the infected seed. So that is also an advantage for transplantation. Next, moving to the fourth step, replenishing the soil or adding manures or fertilizers. What is meant by the word? What do you understand by the word replenishing? Making the soil to get back all the nutrients its own. Can be by field fallow method or crop rotation method or mixed cropping method. You're just leaving the land for some months so that the soil is regaining all the main nutrients NPK. What is NPK? Nitrogen, then phosphorus and potassium. So all the main nutrients are made by the soil microorganisms or earthworm and or leguminous plants which are there in the field is giving the nutrients back to the soil. Then what is crop rotation? So crop rotation means we are growing one type of crop in a particular season. The next time we are choosing another type of crop which does not want the nutrients which is not there in that soil. So crop rotation method, mixed cropping, at a time two different kinds of crops which requires two different types of nutrients we are choosing and growing at same time. That is called mixed cropping method. So these are the methods we are following, these three methods we are following for replenishing the soil. Then next is adding manures or fertilizers. In case if we are not following these three methods, directly we can use adding manures or fertilizers to save time. So manures are the natural substances formed by the decomposition of plants and animals. And fertilizers, we are making the fertilizers using some chemicals which contain the main nutrients nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium, NPK. Examples for fertilizers are given here: ammonium sulfate, urea, superphosphate and potash. Then what are the main differences between manures and fertilizers? I told you manures are natural thing, fertilizers are based from, it is made from chemicals. So there are possibility of getting soil pollution by these fertilizers. Once the water flows through the field, it is carried to the streams, water streams also. So fertilizers are not suggested to use always. These manures are not very rich in NPK. Some nutrients are present in less concentration. So we cannot expect all NPK are present in this natural organic substance called manures. But fertilizers we are making artificially by adding the correct concentration of NPK. So growth will be more if you use fertilizers. And manures are less soluble in water, so slowly the roots can absorb to the plant. But here fertilizers, here it is more soluble in water so that the plant can absorb easily. Then this is manures are prepared in fields and fertilizers are prepared in factories. So here manures, it contains a lot of humus, but fertilizers does not contain any content of humus. These are the main differences between manures and fertilizers. Here, one thing I forgot to tell you, what is the advantage of soil preparation? By using the method tilling or ploughing, by doing tilling or ploughing, it makes all the nutrients which is settled on the top or bottom to mix it properly. Second is, it makes all the unwanted pests or weeds to come out. We can uproot the weeds by this method. It makes all the pests to come out without disturbing the crop production. It makes the root to respire properly. It makes all the soil microorganisms to respire properly because of loosening and turning of the soil. Then, what is the next advantage of tilling or ploughing? Here, even it makes the irrigation proper. So, these are the advantages of tilling or ploughing. So, here, I have covered only the first part of this lesson. And next part, I'll be taking later. So, hope you have understood this session. So, thank you.